Alright guys, there was one last thing I was going to do on the Jeep. I mean, I wasn't going to even mess with it, but this is a rear seatbelt, and it's all jammed. And if you bang it, sometimes it'll come out, but it goes back in, and it's broke again. Even if you release it, it's just broke. So I've been reading up on it a little bit. Some people can spray some WD-40s in the mechanisms, but you can't get it out until you get this riveted plastic cover off. I do have rivets to replace this, so that's why I'm going to go ahead and see if I can drill it off. You're just drilling to get the head of the rivet off. And I got it. So you got the head of the rivet, and it just popped off there. And then I can get the seatbelt out here. Let me see how this works. Now, since this thing is probably totally invalidated and illegal now anyway, I could just show you the seatbelt stuff. So there's a little ball in there. And this is fixed now. But the problem was, so you have this ball here. And see that little purple lever on it? Now, this was installed here. Like this, the two nodes go through the holes. But see, that lever slipped out from under this hook. So that's the only thing that stops it from unlocking. See, it locks in there. So you put this under to lift it. Then you put this into the two holes. And then, of course, you put your cover on it. And then it only should lock. Of course, it still doesn't even work. When the ball drops and puts weight on it, it's a ball issue. But you can see now, if I hold it here, now it comes all the way out because that yellow piece isn't dropping. But there's some kind of thing, like if it hits or gets in a crash, this ball is supposed to drop and pull this yellow down in there and kind of lock the gear. But this might have been just a simple issue, and I'll put it back together and just play with it for a while and test it, but I'm sure as soon as you open this up, it's illegal to use anyway. So if you're familiar with a rivet gun, these are just different size holes. Luckily it has a good one for my big thick rivet here. I'm just going to re-rivet this thing, so I'll get it back in here properly. So I'm going to line up this hole right here, rivet it in like that. Now I gotta hold it, and then you kind of pump the rivet, and it's going to spread out the flange under it until it breaks. It's gonna stretch it, and it ratchets up, and it's gonna snap when it's done. One more, this is it. And you release. And you get out your front piece, and that is a perfect rivet right there. And see, it expands the back of that rivet so it can't come out. That's not the cleanest rivet I ever seen, but it's perfectly functional. And the front looks really good, of course, too. But anyway, I don't think this actually is gonna work because it's supposed to catch under extreme stuff. I kind of got it the other way now. Instead of two stuck, it's two unstuck. And if you knock the ball a certain way, you could get it to stay, possibly. Might have been an upside down knock. But at least I got a lot of info on how a seatbelt works. You know what? I think it's actually working properly. See, on an impact, it sticks. That's how it's supposed to work, exactly. You take a big hit, it locks in place, right? Loosens up, big hit, it locks. This is a perfectly functioning seatbelt. So I'm pretty stoked about that. Looks like it did work. Still, of course, legally speaking, the seatbelt should never be used again. I know that. You don't need to tell me that in the comments. But I'm just saying, looks like I did fix it, and it is functional.